hurting my eyes!
That guy needed some solar eclipse glasses. If you like the ability to see with your eyes and are planning on observing an upcoming solar eclipse, I have to talk to you. This is going to be a purely informational video, and I'll be focusing on information coming out of the American Astronomical Society, aka the AAS. By the end of the video, you'll know where to find safe solar glasses, and you'll also learn about the ISO 12312 standard and why it is so important. Before I continue, I want to mention that the AAS, NASA, and ISO does not certify or approve any kind of eclipse product. Anyone claiming otherwise either don't know what they're talking about or they're lying to you. This video is not meant to be intensive, but I plan on summarizing some of the information that I believe that you should know. Many people probably don't even know that the AAS organization exists, and they tend to get their information from things like the news media, friends and family, and social media. But I hope that the word about the AAS gets around, especially their Eclipse resource website at eclipse.aas.org. The link is in the description below. So what does the AAS say about safely viewing the sun? Some of it's common sense and some of it's not. So first they say, you need to protect your eyes. Looking at the sun without protection is unsafe except during the total eclipse phase, which only lasts a few minutes. Sunglasses and other eyewear are not safe. You must use solar eclipse glasses that follow the ISO 12312-2 International Safety Standard. More on purchasing glasses in the ISO standard soon. If you have glasses with the old CE standard and no ISO standard listed, then get rid of them and get some new glasses. If your eclipse glasses look damaged, replace them. Don't risk dangerous radiation leaking through. Do not look at the sun through an unfiltered camera, telescope, binoculars, or any other optical device. Unfiltered in this case means that there is no solar filter in front of the optics. For safe solar viewing, you want to make sure that a solar filter is the first thing the sunlight hits before hitting the optics. And if you don't have glasses, use projection to view the sun safely, such as using a pinhole camera. And if you have any questions, talk to an astronomer. If you don't know any astronomer that you can reach out to me. I am always available. Ask me any questions you want about the eclipse. Now let's talk about purchasing eclipse glasses. You should always purchase eclipse glasses from AAS recognized manufacturers and resellers only. Now pay attention to the wording I've used. I said AAS recognized and not approved or certified, because as I mentioned earlier, AAS does not approve or certify anyone. The AAS states that any vendor listed on their website has demonstrated that their product meets the safety requirements set forth by the ISO 12312-2 standard. Once you head to eclipse.aas.org, if you hover over the eye safety option here, you have a link to suppliers of safe solar viewers. One thing to know about this page is that as of February 8, 2024, this page has been frozen. That means no new vendors are being listed. So what's here is final in terms of what the AAS recognizes. And the AAS mentions that even if a vendor is not listed on this page, it does not mean that their products are unsafe. If a store or reseller or manufacturer is not listed on this page, I would recommend skipping it. The nice people at AAS did the work of vetting every vendor listed here, and we trust that their products are safe. This page has also changed quite a bit over the last year. Last year was a little bit more simpler, where it had manufacturers and resellers of eclipse glasses, but this year they organize the page in a very different way. So we see the North American manufacturers, telescope companies, importers, authorized dealers with a ton of vendors and resellers here, North American large retail chains, importers and dealers from China, and information on the StarNet program, other solar viewers, as well as other filters for telescopes, binoculars, and camera lenses, as well as some more information. So the idea of the ASS making this page like this is to be very informative. And if you read through this, there is a ton of information about what each of these categories are. Unfortunately, although there's a lot of information here to the everyday consumer, it's not easy to read through, so it's not as user experience friendly. So if you come across a vendor online and you want to make sure that they are recognized with the AAS, once you come here, you can do Control F, find, let's say I'm looking for Thousand Oaks Optical, and they are listed here. So this is going to be the best way, the quickest way to find something. Otherwise, you have a lot of vendors, a lot of lists, a lot of stores to look through. The AAS also provides guidance on purchasing retail chains, such as Walmart, Lowe's, and even Cracker Barrel. They're confident that some, not all, locations of these major retailers sell ISO-compliant safe eclipse glasses, made by one of the manufacturers listed above. They also warn you to be careful about buying things on their website because their online resellers may not source their glasses from the same location and they may not be safe. So what that means is that stay away from gas station eclipse glasses and retail chains not listed here, even if they're the last resort, because it's not worth it. And share that information with everyone you know, because we all know someone who's going to go to 7-Eleven and try to buy some eclipse glasses. But they do advise against searching for eclipse glasses on Amazon, eBay, Temu, and other online marketplaces. In 2017, a whole bunch of sellers on Amazon and eBay were outed for selling fake and counterfeit eclipse glasses, which are extremely dangerous. So be careful where you get your glasses. If you're watching this video at 9 a.m. on April 8th, and there's no way you can find eclipse glasses for the event, don't worry. You can use something called pinhole projection, where you can use basically your hands to create pinholes to see the shadow of the sun, or you can make one out of a shoebox. The AES has guidance on how to do some of this on their website, and you can also Google for how to create your own shoebox pinhole camera. So that was a lot of talk about the AES, and I use the word ISO a lot. So what does that actually mean? More specifically, what is the ISO 12312-2:2015 standard? So ISO is an organization that sets international safety standards for many products. And the number 12312 refers to the section on eye and face protection. The 2 is the second part, which covers items that are specifically designed for direct observations of the sun. And the 2015 is when it was last revised. The standard is reviewed every 5 years, and it is current as of 2020. So we should expect to see another revision or update or confirmation in 2025. The ISO 12312-2 requires that the maximum luminous transmittance of visible and ultraviolet light fall below these levels as seen on this graphic, and the IR transmittance is generally 3%, a little bit higher. This standard will never apply to sunglasses or X-ray film, even if they feel like they block a lot of sunlight, because they may not block ultraviolet and infrared radiation. This standard also does not apply to all solar filters, especially those that are meant to be used for photography only. So be careful when you buy neutral density filters and even some Bader solar film, which are rated for photography only. What that means is that although you can use it to take pictures, do not look through an eyepiece or a viewfinder of your camera, especially if you're using a DSLR, because that mirror will send direct sunlight to your eye. Thousand Oaks Optical is the only solar sheet I use because they're rated for both visual and photography use. ISO does not test or certify products. They set the standards, and those standards must be tested by laboratories who are equipped to test those products. What this means is that if you see anyone claiming that their products are ISO certified, ISO compliant, ISO registered, or ISO approved, they either don't know what they're talking about or they're lying to you. The proper way to say that a product follows the ISO standard is to add a little blurb like this that says conforms to and meets the transmission requirements of ISO 12312-2 as seen on this pair from American Paper Optics. ISO also doesn't allow non-ISO member organizations to use their logo, but companies do it anyway. But that goes into the trademark territory, and I'm going to leave it at that. And to add to that and to repeat what I said earlier, NASA also does not certify or approve any kind of solar eclipse products. But you will come across products online that say, hey, we are NASA approved. They're lying to you. In my next video, I plan on testing 4 more eclipse products that I purchased from AES recognized vendors. I will hopefully test them out and get that video online in a couple of days. Be sure to check out eclipse.aes.org for a ton more information on solar eclipses and safe solar viewing. Don't damage your eyes. It's not worth it. Until next time, clear skies.